After noting that moon rocks give off radiation, and then suggesting that that makes them identical to common meteorites found on Earth, which it doesn't, Jarrah jumps into the conspiracist's claim that the chief architect of the American space program, Wernher von Braun, went to Antarctica in 1966 to collect meteorites that would later be passed off as moon rocks brought back by the Apollo astronauts. This von Braun claim quickly circulated the internet shortly after it was introduced in the year 2000 by alleged truth seeker Aron Ranen in his supposedly critically acclaimed mockumentary, Did We Go? Jarrah borrows heavily from Ranen's video in his Exhibit D series.
On that note, it is worth noting that in 1966, Wernher von Braun, the Nazi rocket scientist who built the Saturn V, took an extended trip to Antarctica.
Another note worth noting is that he was there for a week. I wouldn't exactly consider that an extended trip, and he was there in January 1967, not 1966. And, of course, Jarrah has to start off by tagging von Braun as being a Nazi. After all, everyone knows that all Nazis are liars and meteorite hoarders. Besides, for what other reason than meteorite gathering would a Nazi scientist want to go to Antarctica anyway? First off, whether von Braun was a Nazi or not has nothing to do with moon rocks. Nonetheless, Jarrah tries to invalidate the entire Apollo space program by discrediting one man's character. This tactic is called poisoning the well. As for a reason for von Braun to go to Antarctica, according to this article on the Texas Tech University website, von Braun sent a letter to Red Raiders famed geologist and curate F. Alton Wade well before his trip, asking for a suggestion on a good place to train the Apollo astronauts, and Wade pointed von Braun to Antarctica.
In searching Wikipedia for information on this, one comes across the following. During the local summer of 1966 to 1967, von Braun participated in a U.S. government expedition to Antarctica. The expedition was one of the first to systematically search the ice surface for meteorites believed to originate from the moon, for later use as reference material.
This is interesting. If you look at the Wernher von Braun article on Wikipedia today, it doesn't say this. Jarrah published his Exhibit D video series on YouTube on January 4th, 2009. If you search back through the Wikipedia archives to that time, or even a couple of months before, the article doesn't say anything about meteorites then either. In fact, you have to search back to before January 2008 to find this wording. That tells me that Jarrah is intelligent enough to search the Wikipedia archives for previous versions of articles, and that means he had to have viewed the comments associated with each revision that he pulled.
Shortly after this article was brought up in debate, it was promptly changed to: the goal of the field trip was to determine whether the experience gained by U.S. scientific and technological community during the exploration of Antarctic wastelands would be useful for manned exploration of space.
Debate? There was no debate. Here's what happened. On June 23, 2007, Wiki author Gliss2, a major contributor to the von Braun article on Wikipedia, added a description of the expedition to Antarctica. What appears to be a reference note in that article is actually a link to a photo of von Braun at the South Pole. A picture may prove that at some time he was somewhere where there's snow, but it doesn't tell you what he did there. So on July 1, 2007, after being dinged for not providing a source, Gliss2 added various references to the article, including one for the expedition to Antarctica. He cites an article from Popular Science magazine, dated May 1967. 6 months later, on January 2, 2008, an anonymous author, a bright, intelligent young lad from the Netherlands, from the city of Eindhoven, actually, a truth seeker, someone who doesn't just trust everything he reads on the internet, actually found the edition of Popular Science and read the article. Finding that the article does not mention meteorites or meteorite gathering at all, he then updated the Wikipedia article with the true purpose of the trip, as stated in the source article. And that is why the wording changed. Jarrah knew this, Jarrah had to have seen the revision history when he traipsed through the archives looking for that particular revision of the article that he used in the video. Again, Jarrah builds a straw man, this time suggesting that there was some debate over what wording should be used. There was no debate. The meteorite crap was simply thrown out, and the truth was inserted. And just how can we prove what the truth is? Well, like the unknown lad from the Netherlands, we can look at the popular science article, of course. Fortunately, you don't even have to drive down to your local public library to see if they still have a fish machine. Every edition of popular science from about 1950 on is available on Google Books. I'm surprised you can't link directly to them from a YouTube video. This article, A Spaceman Looks at Antarctica, was written by contributing editor Wernher von Braun. Where have I heard that name before? Anyway, it tells how four NASA execs went to Antarctica to evaluate it as a proving ground for working the kinks out of the lunar rover and testing life-detecting equipment intended for deployment on Mars. That was the purpose of their week-long visit to that continent in January 1967. The four NASA execs who participated in this trip to Antarctica included not only Wernher von Braun, director of NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center, but also Dr. Robert R. Gilruth, director of the Manned Spacecraft Center in Houston, Dr. Maxime Faget, Houston's director of engineering and development, and another former Nazi scientist, Dr. Ernst Strulinger, head of the Research Project Laboratory at the Marshall Space Flight Center. Four of the most handsomely paid directors in all of NASA. In most sectors of corporate America, a trip of this sort is typically called a boondoggle. If there was any ulterior motive for the trip, it was to put the Texas and Alabama boys together on what was then a multi-day round trip flight and get them to iron out their petty differences, as was proposed in von Braun's biography, Dreamer of Space, which also makes no reference to meteorites. I'm not going to read the popular science article to you. You can do that. Check the sidebar of this video for the link. Jarrah says much more about von Braun's trip to Antarctica, but this is a good place to stop for now. We will conclude our study of Jarrah's character assassination in the next video. Ciao, Moon Hoax Conspirators. Wherever you are.